Holy God, we come to worship. We come to worship and to remember. We come to worship and to witness. Today is the fourth Sunday in Lent. During this season of the church year, we are focusing on five different people who were present in the story of Jesus' passion. Today's banner depicts the face of Pilate, the man who authorized the crucifixion of Jesus. His story comes to us from Luke 23. Then the assembly rose as a body and brought Jesus before Pilate. They began to accuse him, saying, "We found this man perverting our nation, forbidding us to pay taxes to the emperor, and saying that he himself is the Messiah, a king." Then Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He answered, "You say so." Then Pilate said to the chief priest and the crowds, "I find no basis for an accusation against this man."
Jealousies that divide families and nations, for rivalries that create strife and warfare.
Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal,
for reluctance in sharing the gifts of God, for carelessness with the fruits of creation.
Thank you.
power to heal and to forgive. Graciously cleanse us from all sin. Make us strong. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Today I have rolled away from you the disgrace of Egypt, and so that place is called Gilgal to this day. While the Israelites were camped in Gilgal, they kept the Passover in the evening on the 14th day of the month in the plains of Jericho. On the day after the Passover, on that very day, they ate the produce of the land, unleavened cakes and parched grain. The manna ceased on the day that they ate the produce of the land, and the Israelites no longer had manna. They ate the crops of the land of Canaan that year. The word of the Lord. Today our psalm is Psalm 32, and we'll read it responsively by whole verse. Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven, and those whose sin is put away. While I held my tongue, my bones withered away because of my groaning all day long. Then I acknowledged my sin to you, and I did not conceal my guilt. Therefore, all the faithful will make their prayers to you in time of trouble. When the great waters overflow, they shall not reach them. I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go. I will guide you with my eye. Great are the tribulations of the wicked, but mercy embraces those who trust in the Lord. Our second reading is from the second book of Corinthians, chapter 5. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from our human point of view. Even though we once knew Christ from the human point of view, we know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting the trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors of Christ, since God is making his appeal through us. We entreat you to, on behalf of Christ, to be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteous of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
There was a man who had two sons. The younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the share of the property that will belong to me. So he divided his property between them. A few days later, the younger son gathered all he had and traveled to a distant country. And there he squandered his property in desolate living. When he had spent everything, a severe famine took place throughout that country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him into his fields to feed the pigs. Now he would have gladly have filled himself with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. And when he came to himself, he said, "How many of my father's hired hands have bread enough and to spare? But here I am dying of hunger. I will get up and go to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me like one of your hired hands.' So he set off and went to his father, and while he was still far off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. He ran and put his arms around him and kissed him. Then the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his slaves, 'Quickly bring out a robe, the best one, and put it on him. And a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. And get the fatted calf and kill it. Let us eat and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. Was lost and is found.' And they began to celebrate. Now his elder son was in the field, and when he came and approached the house, he heard music and dancing. He called one of the slaves and asked what was going on. He replied, 'Your brother has come, and your father has killed the fatted calf, because he has got him back safe and sound.' And then he became angry and refused to go in. His father came out and began to plead with him. But he answered his father, 'Listen, for all these years I have been working like a slave for you, and I have never disobeyed your command. Yet you have never given me even a young goat that I might celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours comes back, who has devoured your property with prostitutes, you killed the fatted calf for him.' And then the father said to him, 'Son, you are always with me. All that is mine is yours. But we had to celebrate and rejoice because this brother of yours was dead and has come to life. He was lost and has been found.' The Gospel of our Lord.
Children, please come forward.
start loving you when you were five? You're not five yet, are you? Can you help me with your hands? Stretch them out how much God loves us. Stretch it out. Do you think He loves us this much? I think so. I'll bet He loves us this much, and guess what that looks like? A cross. Yeah, it does. He loves us that much. He's always going to love us, and that's the cool thing in the world. And we'll have to study those pictures over there. And there's crosses on here, too. There's faces over there. Thanks a lot.
For the church, that it may be a community of reconciliation and welcome those lost, estranged, or alienated from their homes or communities. Hear us, O God. For those preparing for baptism at Easter, that they clothe them in the garments of salvation and welcome them to the table of celebration. Hear us, O God. For the governments of the world, that they not squander the resources of the earth, but use them for the good of creation and all of its inhabitants. Hear us, O God. For the families and homes of the congregation, that they may be places of forgiveness, acceptance, and nurture. Help us, hear us, O God. We give thanks for the saints. Bring us to your eternal home, that we may rejoice in the inheritance of your grace. Hear us, O God.
Lutheran, Linda, Roma Brown, Paul Long, Larry Zachary, Mary Brown, Paul Cusino, and Jeff Warner. We pray for Rudy Eichhoff, Walter Thompson, Pat Badenhoff, and Alfred and Rita Priebe, for Marjorie Downs, Pete Miller, Brent Leiber, and Alexa Jennings, Paul Panning, Emma Myers, Andrew Williams, and C.A. For Will Benfeld, and Jordan James, and Jeff Kiefer, for Herman Campbell, Brent Thompson, Rudy and Ann Raby, and Kelly Garst, Naomi Rhodes, George and Cindy Pope, and Jamie Bossman. For Alita Panning, Kelly Troyer, Linda Hill, and Bethany Wolf, Lois Weekers, Ellen Carlisle, J.P., and Brian Shank. For Derek Mooring, Don and Susan Dravis, Alice Langenhoff, and Ted Tittenmeyer. For Katie Michaelis, Crystal Garcia, Lorna Bossman, Josh Badenhoff, Sandy Bossman, Louisa Bevel, and Shirley Myers Pages. For KT, Betsy Nix, Joe, John and Dorothy Harms, Landon Zunk, Deb Shank, Sarah Lenhart, and Dick Brown. We pray for Rufus King, Carol Barrow, Ruth M. Eichhoff, Allie Grace Small, and Tammy Porter. For Jeff Brown, Brennan, Marlene Cryer, and Dave and Betty Meyer. For Amy Rodenball, Linda Loss, Norma Strayer, and Josh Bevel. For Robert Klassman, Pauline Downard, Bill Winsman, and Fred Close. For Larry Ginneman, Roman Strom, Jeannie Curtis, Eleanor Engler, Melanie Simpson, Charlotte Longren, Stan and Eileen Mabee, for Nelda Morris, and for Pastor Norman Gridley, for all those who name now in our hearts. That you and